Chronicles of the Echoesphere. In a world not so different from our own, a group of unlikely explorers found themselves on the precipice of a discovery that would challenge their understanding of reality. This tale takes place in a town named Havenbrook, nestled in the heart of the rolling, verdant hills of the Echo Valley. Havenbrook was a place where the fabric of time and space seemed to fray and intertwine in mesmerizing ways, where echoes of past events lingered, replaying themselves like forgotten memories. Our journey begins with a young man named Samuel Whitman, a brilliant but introverted high school student with a passion for quantum physics. Samuel had always been a curious soul, and his fascination with the mysteries of the universe led him to explore the Echo Valley. Armed with his scientific knowledge and an antique journal passed down through generations, he delved into the peculiar occurrences that had troubled his family for centuries. One rainy autumn evening, as the heavens wept their endless tears, Samuel stumbled upon a peculiar relic in the attic of his family's ancient Victorian mansion. The relic was a metal compass with intricate engravings and an old leather-bound book. It was this compass that held the key to unlocking the secrets of the Echo Valley. It was said that the compass had the power to guide its possessor through the rifts of time. Samuel knew he had to assemble a team of like-minded individuals to explore the Echo Valley secrets. He sought the guidance of his high school physics teacher, Professor Eleanor Hart, a wise and enigmatic woman with a deep appreciation for the unknown. Professor Hart, in her twilight years, welcomed the opportunity to partake in a grand adventure. She believed that the Echo Valley held the answers to questions that had perplexed scientists for generations. Their quest led them to an unlikely group of companions. First was Mark Donovan, a former firefighter who had seen his share of inexplicable events in his time. Then there was Lily Chen, an elderly librarian with a passion for history and an uncanny ability to decipher ancient languages. Together, they formed a team of explorers that would journey to the Echo Valley, setting out in search of answers. The journey was not without its perils. As they entered the Echo Valley, the very fabric of reality seemed to waver. The landscape transformed into a surreal dreamscape, where echoes of the past played out in mesmerizing loops. They witnessed scenes from different eras, a bustling ancient marketplace, a colonial town square, a futuristic city, and moments from their own lives. One evening, while they camped beneath a sky painted with the colors of a thousand sunsets, they discovered a mysterious anomaly. A shimmering portal appeared, leading them into the heart of the Echoesphere. Here, the echoes of Earth's past events were not mere apparitions, but tangible occurrences. The explorers found themselves in the midst of a swirling vortex, where time became a flowing river, and past and present intermingled. As they traversed through this strange realm, they encountered echoes of historical figures who had left an indelible mark on humanity. They observed Aristotle pondering the cosmos, Leonardo da Vinci sketching his inventions, and Amelia Earhart soaring through the skies. Each encounter left them awestruck, and their understanding of time's fluidity grew. However, the Echoesphere was not without its mysteries and dangers. The explorers soon realized that their presence had disrupted the natural flow of the echoes, creating ripples in the fabric of time. As they encountered echoes of themselves, they were confronted with the profound question of whether their actions were predetermined or influenced by their presence. One particularly chilling encounter left them shaken. In a shadowy corner of the Echoesphere, they saw echoes of a destructive event that mirrored a catastrophic incident from their own world's history. The event had resulted in loss of life and untold suffering. The realization that their presence had affected these echoes weighed heavily on their hearts. As they continued their journey, the explorers uncovered the journal's secrets. It revealed that Samuel's ancestors had discovered the Echo Valley centuries ago and had used the compass to visit the Echoesphere. They, too, had grappled with the consequences of their actions on the echoes. The journal spoke of the importance of understanding the boundaries of time and the nature of existence. In their quest for answers, they came to a profound revelation. Time, they realized, was not a linear progression, but a vast interconnected web where past, present, and future coexisted. Their actions in the Echoesphere were not predetermined, but they had a responsibility to make choices that would resonate positively through the echoes. With this newfound knowledge, the explorers made a solemn commitment to right the wrongs they had inadvertently caused. They began a quest to mend the disrupted echoes, seeking redemption for the suffering they had witnessed. Through their actions, they attempted to guide the echoes toward more hopeful outcomes, weaving threads of positivity through the Echoesphere. Their journey through the Echo Valley continued for many months, and the explorers found themselves profoundly changed by the experience. Samuel's understanding of quantum physics had evolved beyond scientific theory, touching the very essence of reality itself. Professor Hart had uncovered mysteries that transcended her academic knowledge, and Mark and Lily had discovered the depths of their own humanity. As they ventured deeper into the Echoesphere, they encountered a pivotal moment and event in which they witnessed their own arrival in the Echo Valley. This paradoxical occurrence forced them to question the nature of their existence. Were they merely echoes themselves, playing out their destinies in an endless loop? The final chapters of their journey led them to the heart of the Echo Valley, where the boundaries between dimensions blurred. Here, they confronted the ultimate question of whether they were destined to be mere echoes or had the power to transcend the loops of time. In a climactic moment, Samuel made a decision that would alter the course of their adventure. He chose to release the compass's power, freeing it to guide others to the Echoesphere and continue the exploration of time's mysteries. This act of selflessness broke the cycle, allowing the echoes to evolve and the explorers to transcend their own destinies. With the compass's power relinquished, the Echo Valley began to shift and change. The explorers saw echoes of the valley's past merging and creating new narratives, a harmonious dance of time that transcended the loops they had once witnessed. They watched as the echoes of their actions spread hope and positivity throughout the Echoesphere. As they returned to their own world, the explorers felt a deep sense of fulfillment. They had journeyed through the Echoesphere, questioned the boundaries of time, and discovered the nature of their own existence. They had witnessed the interplay of echoes from Earth's past and had learned that their actions could shape the future, even in the most enigmatic corners of the universe. The Chronicles of the Echoesphere, recorded in Samuel's journal, became a testament to their extraordinary journey. It was a story that would inspire generations, from high school students to the elderly, to ponder the mysteries of time and the boundless possibilities that lay beyond the limits of their own understanding. In the end, the Echo Valley remained a place where echoes of the past continued to play out, but now with a touch of hope and redemption. It was a reminder that, in the grand tapestry of existence, every action held the power to influence the course of time and shape the destiny of the universe.